OK, now we're joined by another special guest. It's Davy Jones from Brighton Climate Action Network, or Brighton CAN as it's known. Welcome to you. Nice to see you.
Thank you, Mike.
Now, you're here ahead of a series of events next week, aren't you?
That's right. Yes, we are. It's going to be the 21st meeting of the United Nations Climate Panel meeting in Paris at the end of the month, early December. And so there's a whole network of organisations here in Brighton who are going to be carrying out a series of actions, a week of action, a time to act week next week. Lots of things happening because the Secretary General of the United Nations says that climate change is the single biggest issue facing humanity, and we feel that it is time now for us to act and to do something serious about it.
This is non-party, non-political really.
That's right, yes. Yeah. I mean, there are people from across different parties that are participating in it. And lots of activists, lots of campaigns, going to be meetings on things like energy, trade union, climate change, jobs, meetings with different politicians, meetings with different campaigns like the Arctic campaigners who stopped Shell recently from drilling in the Arctic, campaigners from Bulcombe who beat fracking up there, just to show that we can make a change with climate change. We can make a difference.
So you've got the Paris Climate Change Conference, that's next week.
That's November the 30th to 11th of December.
But next week is the Brighton Climate Action Week. Mm. And what do you hope to achieve by this?
Well, we want to make people aware that there are a lot of people who care very, very much about this issue and want to see change. At the moment, we have a situation where our government in this country has just cut by almost 90% the subsidies for renewable energy, while at the same time increasing the subsidies for traditional fossil fuels. And that's crazy. Almost every other country in the world is investing in its renewable energy industry. We seem to be trying to destroy it in this country, which is just madness. So we want to turn that around and make people aware that climate change is the most important issue facing us and that we can make a difference. We can make change.
Will climate change going to happen anyway? I mean, we've had the Ice Age, we've had all the different ages. Every couple of centuries, the world changes. Surely that it's just a natural phenomenon.
Well, afraid not. 99% of scientists wouldn't agree with you about that. They would say that actually it is a man-made crisis that we have now.
99% of people you know may say that, but 99% may not say it to me.
No, 99% of scientists say that. And the point is that we now know that the world's climate has gone up now by an average of one degree centigrade since the Industrial Revolution as a result of man-made activity. We know that it only needs to go up another 0.5% and some island countries in the world now will literally be lost under the waters. And if it goes up to 2 degrees centigrade, there is a real chance of runaway climate change where we wouldn't really know how easy it would be to stop it.
Has this not happened before?
No, nothing before.
You mean there was no, like when the Ice Age, for example, suddenly seas were developed, which you think this is all a myth?
That if we don't change things, it's going to get a lot worse. And it's already bad for about people in Senegal, where their normal crops, which are increasing in the climate there, and they're now no longer able to do that. And if we think we have problems now with, for example, refugees from around the world, from war zones, it won't be 2 million, 3 million, it will be hundreds of millions of people unable to make a living in countries and needing to move around the world. If we want a world fit for our children and our grandchildren, we have to do something and change, stop our reliance on fossil fuels.
Not so many years ago, we were warned about global warming. The year after that, I think it was one of the coldest winters and summers we've had for a long time.
Ah, yes, but it doesn't work like that, Mike. I mean, it's understandable we all sort of think of that. We all sort of think, oh, ring on after this year's summer. You think, oh, bring on climate change, global warming.
Bring on a bit of global warming,
It won't work like that. I mean, if the annual temperature in the world may go up, but it might be that in some parts of the world it would actually get worse. And in this country, the forecast is that we will actually have much more rain, much more flooding. The sorts of flooding which we've seen in the last few years will become mainstream, will become much more common, and the situation won't necessarily be any better, be much worse in this country.
I go back to you saying 99% of people wouldn't agree with what I said, and I'd probably go the opposite way. A lot of people think it's a con.
Well, they're wrong. I look at it this way. If 99% of medical people said to you, you've got to have this particular operation, you'd go along with it. So why on earth don't you go along with it when 99% of the experts on this say that if we don't act now, the world that your children, grandchildren and mine grow up in is going to be a really difficult place to live in. We have to take action. And we have to do it now.
Isn't it just a way of scientists keeping in employment, giving themselves something to do?
I don't think so. I mean,
there's not mad scientists around, who suddenly think of these ideas.
I think the scientists are genuinely very, very worried about this. And so now are most of the politicians around the world. You know, in other countries, they've moved away from the traditional fossil fuel industries. You know, in Germany now, the renewables is a massive part of their economy. It's only here in this country that nothing really is happening on that front, that the government seems to be trying to stop the renewable energy industry. So we're going to have a series of actions next week, a lot of activities right through the week. You can go to the Brighton Can website or its Facebook page, find out all the details of them, and people can get involved. They can have these discussions about, is it really happening, is it really serious?
I've been having these discussions for years on my radio show, for example, and I've just never been convinced of what I've been told is right.
Well, I'm convinced, certainly, having seen all the evidence, having listened to the people who know about these things, who look at the Arctic ice melting in a way that it's never, ever melted before in human history, and who feel now that there's a real danger that by next summer or the summer after that, there won't be any Arctic ice left at all during the summer months. And that has a huge impact on the world. The sea temperature rises, the sea levels rise, a lot of the basic components of life in the oceans die out as a result of global warming on the sea,
for example. So how do we change things? What do we do? It's all right to sit around talking about it, but it's got to practically do. I mean, let's go back to plastic bags for a minute. You know, why stop supermarkets, although making them sell plastic bags, instead of banning plastic bags altogether, if it's so bad for the environment?
Well, I'd be happy to ban plastic bags. There's now a 10-mile area of the Pacific Ocean, which is just plastic bags and other rubbish which is thrown into the ocean. So we have to stop doing that, obviously. But the real thing is that we need to change our reliance on fossil fuels. We have to stop burning coal, burning gas, and so on, and oil, and we have to move towards renewable. I mean, the clue is in the title, renewable. It's always going to be there. And we can, if we use wind power, if we use solar power, if we use wave power.
I'm going to give you a chance to keep convincing me and everybody else straight after we have a break. Okay.
Thank you.
We're talking to Davy Jones. We're talking about everything that I never really know what's going on, but I'll know more straight after this break. Don't go away. I'm still joined by Davy Jones from Brighton, of course, and the climate change conference coming up. So much happening about this. And you call me a bit of a sceptic. I suppose I am in a way. But surely a lot of what we're seeing has to do with the Earth's axis and the sun, and things go off kilter slightly. Doesn't that change things?
Well,
nothing to what we're doing, surely.
Well, that may do, but the real issue for me is the change in the climate that is happening internationally, and which is now proven by scientists all around the world that the amount of CO2, that's carbon dioxide, which we're pumping into the atmosphere, and other gases like that which we're pumping into the atmosphere, is making the whole climate system of the world gradually changing in ways that we don't really fully understand, but which most people think is going to be extremely dangerous for us if we don't stop what we're doing. I mean, if you think of the amount of carbon dioxide we've pumped into the atmosphere, we've pumped more in the last 100 years than we have in the previous 10,000.
That's because the population's grown so much.
It's not just down to population, but even if it was that, I mean, it would also have a big effect on the atmosphere. And the atmosphere has a huge role in terms of the oceans, in terms of people's ability to grow food and so on. And all those things are at risk. And as I said before, you wouldn't take the risk with your own life if you knew, if you were confronted with evidence. And I don't think we should take the risk of our children's lives and our grandchildren's lives when we know that the vast majority of opinion is that if we don't change the way that we live and turn towards renewable sources of energy, then we are at risk of making vast parts of the planet uninhabitable. That's what we have to do.
Are we getting confused sometimes with natural erosion and climate change?
I don't think so. I think what we have here is increasing mountains of evidence that it is human activity which is causing the problem in the world and which we have to address. And the reality is we can make these changes. Other countries are doing this. I mean, Sweden has already declared that it wants to be the first completely carbon neutral country in the next 20 years. If other countries can do this, why can't we? The problem is that it's some of the big companies, multinationals, which have a vested interest, the big fossil fuel companies, have a lot of power over politicians. And they have a vested interest in their investments in coal and oil and gas. And so we're very much taking on those sorts of vested interests at the same time when we're confronting climate change. Because they don't want us to change, because they make a lot of money out of oil, a lot of money out of gas.
Yeah, yeah.
But we have to shift towards renewable forms of energy.
Who are the biggest culprits for creating this problem? Is it going to be America or China?
Well, I mean, historically, it's if you can look at it two different ways. Currently, the biggest CO2 emitter is now China and America. But if you look at it historically, to do with our role in the Industrial Revolution, then the United Kingdom is right up there with the United States as historically one of the worst polluters. In fact, it's mainly the Western countries. It's the northern Western countries which are the main polluters, and it is very much the East and the South which is catching up.
Earlier on, you were quoting an island that's going to vanish.
Yes.
I mean, I remember reading when I was quite young that the UK in a million years' time wouldn't be here. Bournemouth, apparently, in 100 years' time was meant to vanish altogether because it's slowly falling away into the sea.
Yeah. Well, there are the islands I was talking about, Kiribati and Tuvalu, and we had visitors over from them at the Brighthelm just a couple of weeks ago. And these are people whose islands are literally likely to disappear in the next 20 years. I mean, they've already seen sea levels rise to a level which is threatening their whole existence. So, very high tides now bring salt water right across their crops and destroy their crops. Mm-hmm. And it's only a matter of time now. And if we don't do something to stop our the way in which we're currently living our lifestyle, if we don't actually reduce our dependence on fossil fuels, people like that around the world are not going to be able to live where they are.
Is this a massive backward step, though? So, in a way, you almost want to do away with a motor car, you want to do away with aircraft.
No, it's not. I mean, we can use renewable forms of energy for the vast majority of things that we need. I do think we need to look at our lifestyles as well, but we're not going back to the Stone Age. We're not asking people to go back to living in caves and not having a TV or a smartphone, but we are saying, look, these things have got to be
looked at. They all create a problem, don't they?
Of course they do, yes. But if we change how we use our fossil fuels and use renewable energy, change elements of our lifestyle to a way which is more sustainable, then our kids and our grandchildren are going to grow up in a world which is much better. And I mentioned to you earlier, it's not just the Week of Action that we have here. There are people from all over the world are taking action over what's happening. It's not just here in Brighton or just in the UK. There are people all across the world taking action. On the weekend of the 28th, 29th of November, when the climate change conference starts in Paris, there are demonstrations in almost every major capital city of the world, including London, which are going to take place.
Is this a demonstration against the multi-corporations?
This is a demonstration asking the politicians to act. Time to act is the theme of all these things. It's time to stop talking about it. It's time to stop arguing about it, whether it's real. Mm. The time to actually do something and change how we live.
And do people really care, or is this rent-a-mob mentality?
I think people do care increasingly. Mm. People are worried about it. But I think a lot of people in this country feel that it's something which is somewhere else. It's happening in other parts of the world, and maybe it isn't going to affect them yet. But those people who were flooded last year, there was a very interesting a graphic from one of those flooded things where people actually were going around in their little boat in the flooded area with a banner saying, can we talk about climate change now? And I think it's very real. Some people have already experienced what it's likely to mean. Some of us have been a bit fortunate and maybe think we can just carry on as we are, but we can't. And so we're doing all of these things next week. There's also international bike rides to Paris.
I can ask you about that, yes.
Yeah, there are people, bike riders converging on Paris from across the whole of Europe. And there's a UK leg of that. And it comes through Brighton, and in fact it stops in Brighton at the weekend of the 5th and 6th of December, and it's going to be going on to Newhaven. They're all crossing over on the ferry. They're not riding on the ferry, but they'll be sitting down on the ferry, then they'll be cycling all the way down to Paris. There's a few hundred people cycling all the way from Brighton to Paris.
Have you any idea how much smoke a ferry puts out going up into the atmosphere and creating problems?
It would have already been going on that journey regardless of whether it was
but
full
both
of cyclists
ways, you're helping create a problem.
Oh, yes. And every time, yes, my coming on a bus here as well created a problem. Yeah, but if it's
50,
worth...
50 electric,
but it's worth it if I can get across to more people listening to this show that climate change is incredibly important. It is something which affects you. It's not just affects someone else.
As a matter of interest, how many people do you think will go on bikes over to Paris?
Well, I think there's likely to be about 200 bike riders coming from Brighton alone, and there are thousands coming from across the whole of Europe. There's even a walking pilgrimage to Paris, which is coming through Brighton on Monday of next week, stopping at the Brighthelm Centre in the afternoon, of pilgrims, religious folk from different religious orders, different religious persuasions, coming together to walk to Paris. They're obviously taking a little bit longer than the bike riders or the people going by ferry, but they're walking all the way to Paris. Mm-hmm. Because there's such a strength of feeling around the world now that politicians are a bit behind the rest of us. The rest of us want to do something about climate change, but the politicians are so slow to act, so slow to try to confront the problems and to confront the multinationals who have these vested interests.
I say
it's time to act.
I hate to sound like a broken record, but once again, let me repeat that the The Earth has gone through phases over the centuries. And every couple of hundred years, a different phase comes in, a change of climate. Maybe we're accelerating the problem, but it's going to happen anyway, surely.
Well, I think the difference is that in the past, the Ice Age might have crept up on us over 20,000 years. If we're not careful, these changes are going to creep up on us over the next 20 to 30 years. And there's going to be serious problems where crops can't be grown in large parts of the world, where people are going to have to be leaving their countries of origin, their countries of birth, migrating to other parts of the world, going to make the whole migration issue much, much worse than it currently is, much more complicated, much more difficult. And I think we're going to see people really beginning to understand how serious it is. But we want to do that before that happens. If we don't do it now, in 10, 20 years' time, it's going to be a situation where we can't even stop
it. We're running out of time. Just very briefly, the Brighton Climate Change Action Week next week.
Yes.
Where's it happening? Where can we get involved?
All over the place, all across Brighton. Certainly, there's going to be a big event in the Synergy Centre in West Street on the Saturday, the 21st. But go to the Brighton Can website, Brighton Can Facebook page, and you can see all the details of the events. There's something for everybody, different exhibitions, different film shows, and different events, different public meetings, discussions, arguments that we've had, and so on. All through that week, you can find things. Just look up Brighton Can. Brighton Can, it is time to act. Brighton can do it.
David, thank you so much for coming. I appreciate
thank
that.
You.
And good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you. That's Davy Jones. And you don't forget, you can join in next week with the Brighton Climate Change Action Week by going to the CAN website.